Hi, everybody. John Bruno, Fiber Instrument Sales and FIS University. On behalf of myself and Bob Licari, some of you have gotten the chance to see Bob teach a class, does a fantastic job. We'd like to thank everybody who's ever taken our classes. Another little tech tip here. We're going, like I said, we're going electronic. No more Ask, well, I guess we'll continue the Ask Brunos, but we're also going to have some video Ask Brunos. And a common question that I've seen in the past, and one that came up yesterday, is something I want to talk about here today. Real quick fix. Customer was using the Fito S179 splicer. Excellent touchscreen splicer. As you can see here, we've taken out the chucks. We have removable chucks that we can use. We have the 900 micron and the 250 chucks. The customer was trying to splice, and he was having a few issues. So here's our 900 and our 250 chucks for the different size fibers. The customer was having some issues with some spliced on connectors, getting very high attenuation. After a while, kind of figured it out. It was a oddball one that I have seen in the past. I probably should have recognized immediately. When you go to use your splicer and you're using the removable chucks, which I am a really big proponent of, big fan, the one thing he hadn't done was this deck here removes and comes out. We can use our Allen wrench that comes with our cleaver, and we can remove the measurement deck. Problem was, he didn't realize that the chucks fit right inside the cleaver themselves. So what he was doing was, he was measuring up a length that was incorrect for the length of our SOC splice and getting high attenuation results. The easiest fix, when we finally discovered what the problem was we removed this deck, this measurement deck, and now the chuck fits directly into the splicer and we get a perfect cleave length every time. Again, remember, Fiber Instrument Sales for your training. We do corporates and we do our on-site trainings and we go all over the United States. I'd be happy to see you there. And don't forget the Brightside locations this summer up at Racket Lake in the Adirondacks of New York. Thanks again, everybody.